Very warm welcome to Must Know Topics. In this particular series, I'll be taking down various lecturate and GT topics which will be helpful in preparing for various competitive examinations including services selection board interviews. The topic that I'll be covering today will be Defense Research and Development Organization, and this will be the 38th lecturate of the series. I'll be covering this particular topic in four subdivisions, that is introduction part, weakness in DRDO, weapons / equipments developed by DRDO, and improvement of DRDO, or the conclusion part. Coming to the introduction, DRDO is responsible for the development, research programs and requirements for the armed forces. It operates under Ministry of Defense and has 50 laboratories. Now, from the past few years, DRDO has not been able to deliver the weapons and equipments as per the requirements of the armed forces, which has led India to acquire weapons from countries like USA, Russia and Israel. Now, as per a report between 2008 and 2012, India has been dependent on these three countries. Now, it states that India has been dependent on Israel for around 7.2% of exports, on Russia for 68% of exports, and on USA for around 14% of exports. Well, coming to the weakness in DRDO, the major weaknesses in DRDO are low budget, fast development in technology, change in qualitative requirement, average scientist and bureaucratic setup. Now, coming to the low budget part, well, budget mark for DRDO is very low. Well, the major part of the budget is earmarked for Army, Navy and Air Force, and research and development is given low priority, and this is one of the major weakness of DRDO. Fast development in technology. Well, technology is changing very fast, with weapons and equipments being modernized. And because of this fast development, the DRDO is not able to meet the previous requirements itself. Change in qualitative requirement. Now, general staff, which is responsible for providing the qualitative requirement for weapons, keeps changing as per the latest technology. And the QR as per changing as per the recommendations of user units as well. Now, the change in QR delays the production, which is one of the major weakness of DRDO. Average scientist. Well, scientists working with DRDO are of average in nature, and the best talent is working with private companies because of good perks and freedom. And the fifth major weakness of DRDO is the bureaucratic setup. Now, basically, the interference of the bureaucracy, then lack of freedom in professional approach, is also one of the major reasons why DRDO is not able to develop weapons on time. Well, these are the list of weapons / equipments which have been developed by DRDO under joint ventures as well. For example, Arjun, the main battle tank, this project was conceived by DRDO in the year 1974. And 1974, and after many observations by the army, the first batch of 5 main battle tank rolled out of heavy vehicles factory at Audi in 2004. So, well, this can be it can be seen from here that the project was conceived in the year 1974, and it took around 30 long years for rolling out 5 main battle tanks, and this shows the slow pace of DRDO. Sukhoi 30 Mark 1. Well, the Russian aircraft, which is multi-role fighter, has been produced in 2004 by HAL, and 140 more is likely to be produced. So, Sukhoi 30 Mark 1 is under joint venture of India and Russia. Saras, Indian-made civilian aircraft. This project started in the year 1991, and inaugural flight came in August 2004. So, well, even here there is around 14 years of gap, approximately. Tejas, or the light combat aircraft, well, it has been replaced for MiG-21 series, and it was rolled out in Bangalore in 2003, and the first batch was received in the year 2015. So even this took around 12 long years. Now, basically, as per the recent reports, around 83 light combat aircraft is of priority deal for the Indian Air Force, as mentioned by the Chief of Indian Air Force Staff, and moreover, They are planning to create one more squadron of LCA Tejas, light combat aircraft Tejas, at Sulur. Apart from the weapons, DRDO has also taken part in fighting to this pandemic. DRDO is developed the ultraviolet germicidal radiation, which will detect the coronavirus in schools and premises, and it will kill it with the help of ultraviolet rays. Moreover, DRDO also developed the N99 mask this year. Earlier we had N95 mask, which could filter, it was a respirator which could filter around 95% of the particles, but this N99 mask guarantees to filter out 99% of the particles. Then multi-patient ventilators. Now presently DRDO is working on multi-patient ventilators, and as we all know that India has a very less quantity of ventilators when compared with the overall population. So they are planning to make a multi-patient ventilator with the help of which on a single ventilator many patients could survive. So this is one of the latest development which is currently happening. Well, coming to the improvement of DRDO, DRDO can be only improved with the help of following four ways, that is increase in budget. Now basically DRDO gets a very low budget for development and research, and if the budget is increased for DRDO, it will be very helpful for DRDO to invest it in latest research. Now private partnership. Now private partnership is also one of the best ways to improve the weapons and technology. Moreover, recruitment of best scientists. Now basically as we have seen that most of the scientists are working in private companies and they are working for some other countries like NASA's, and they are developing their weapons, they are developing their missiles, they are developing their equipments because of good pay and perks. And if pay and perks are improved in India, specifically in organizations such as DRDO or ISRO, then people will come back to India and they will work for the country. And in this manner, the best scientists can be recruited. Apart from that, competitive examinations can also be conducted. A strict competitive examination with high qualifying marks can be conducted, which will be helpful in tapping down the best scientist. Moreover, the fourth major way is the no change in QR. Now we have seen that repeatedly the regiments change their qualitative requirements. So since the DRDO is receiving varying QR, that is qualitative requirements, from the general staff, it is not able to develop the equipments on time. And if there is no change, if once a particular qualitative requirement is given and DRDO only works on that QR, it will be easy for it to develop and develop and manufacture it on time. So well, I hope this topic had been useful to you. In case you like this video, do hit the like button and subscribe the channel. Thank you.